Okay, we've got a demonstration by the Goju Ryu Karate Do, by Max Kudo, Goju Ryu.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the display of traditional Okinawan Goju Ryu Karate. Hojo on Do, equipment training and body conditioning. With Sensei Max Beddow and Rosalie Goju Tan from Shropshire. Much of the equipment you can see was originally taken from ancient China and the island of Okinawa. The large paperclip type is a conga cane. This is used to condition the whole body, used with one or two people for a variety of exercises. The approximate weight is 60 pounds or 30 kilograms. The conga cane was brought from Hawaii to Okinawa. The tan or barbell is used by one or two people to work on most muscle groups in the body and to condition the arms. The approximate weight is 45 pounds to 20 kilograms. They're originally made from wood and stone, and very often in Okinawa they were made from the type of iron wheel used in this display, and this one is an exact replica. Nigiri Gami, the grip jars, which are not being used at the sensei just going over now to the grip jars. Stone storage jars used in Okinawan karate to strengthen the fingers for holding grappling, arm strength and shoulders. They can weigh up to 20 kilograms when filled with sand and water. Today they're very often replaced with metal dumbbells. Ishisashi, the stone padlocks. Today these are made of steel. These weights can be used for upper body and lower body development. The weight varies from 10 to 12 pounds, which is 5 to 7 kilograms. Normally used to replicate karate techniques, both punches and kicks. The next part of this display is chishi stones, stone lever weights. This equipment is very much traditional Okinawan karate equipment. The weight will vary depending on the experience and the ability of the student. Also, when you look at the wooden shaft, the further down it is, the more difficult the exercise is. It increases the weight quite dramatically. This is used to strengthen grip, the wrist for locks and grappling, also arms and shoulders, back, stomach and legs. All exercises synchronized with breathing and it develops great, great power. The next part of the display is body conditioning. This build up from medium blows to full impact blows to condition the whole of the body. Like in most forms of karate, you'll see a lot of circular movements. Just while we wait for the next piece of equipment, you'll see in pairs, partner press ups and partner squats. Have a go at it sometime, it's not as easy as it looks. This part of the display is the makiwara. There are many variations, but generally they will be setting the ground in a vertical position. The one for this display is portable. You'll see a variety of strikes from different stances. It's used over a period of time, the makiwara helps develop tremendous power and impact. The makiwara is often referred to as the anvil of karate. The calluses that build up on and across the knuckles are only a byproduct of hitting the makiwara. The final part of the display is San Chin. San Chin to the exponents of Goju Ryu is the mainstay and kata for this form of karate. You'll notice the sensei and the other outside testing. The traditional translation for this means three battles. The kata is to do with the relaxation and contraction of the body combined with special breathing techniques again. You'll notice that many of the blows are very, very solid indeed. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the display. Thank you for watching. The kata called San Chin. Shiochi. And Gavin will demonstrate a kata called San Chin. Say bye.
Good travel from North of England to be here.